N. Gokulakrishnan.
अनुभव का बात, अनुभव का.
Honorable Vice Chairman sir, I express my sincere thanks to you for allowing me to speak about on the subject the important bill, Indian Institute of Management bill. The bill declares 20 existing Indian institutes of management as institutions of nation's importance and confers on them the power to grant degrees. We need to increase the number of IIMs in the country. Why I am telling this? We have 29 states and 7 union territories, but we have only 20 IIMs. At least for each state, one means we need at least double the institutions like this. And more important is Pondicherry, the Puducherry and Chennai are the very important educational hubs in South India. We need at least for Chennai and Puducherry one institution or one IIM institution like this. The bill provides for the establishment of the Board of Governors of each IIM, comprising up to 19 members. It will nominate 17 board members, including eminent persons, faculty members, and alumni. The remaining 2 members will be nominees from the central and state governments. And similarly, the board appoints its own chairperson also. Actually, the Board of Governors will appoint the directors of each IIM. Sir, at present, 13 of the 20 Indian institutes of management were functioning without directors. Virtually speaking, these institutes have no administrative heads. So there is an urgent need to fill up the post of directors in all these IIMs. Moreover, some important decisions have to be taken by the government to cater the increasing demands of quality education in the country. First thing is, there is a need to expedite the expansion process of IIMs and their intake capacity so that more students get opportunity to enroll themselves in the best institutes. Also, the creation of more quality of PhD programs to address the issue of shortage of faculties in institutes. Scholarship schemes for PhD program for best of PhD scholars in IIMs need to be created. An academic council of each IIM will determine the academic content, criteria and process for admission to the courses, and third, guidelines for conduct of examinations. A coordination forum will be set up, which will include representation from the 20 IIMs. It will discuss matters of common interest to all IIMs. The bill extends greater autonomy to the board in the performance of these functions. Sir, it is also sad to note that several private business schools are charging huge fees and donations from students seeking admission to MBA or other PG management courses. This needs to be stopped immediately. Private business schools practice all kinds of advertisement gimmicks to entice students to join in their institutes. Various television networks, newspapers, and industry magazines published list of rankings of business schools in India. Some business schools manipulate the data related to campus placement provided to ranking providers. IIM Ahmedabad is the one initiated the Indian placement reporting standards to make placement reports transparent. Till the end of academic year 2014-15, only 9 institutes went for auditing their placement data. with an independent third-party auditor. The media play a bad villain role by giving favorable ranking to some institutions that give advertisements and sponsorships to these media houses, both visual and printing media, and their events. Suggestions to curb these manipulations in business schools ranking included a stoppage of education-related advertisements, consolidating a large number of inferior quality surveys to few high quality surveys that include visits and audits of these institutions and the data they provide, and mandatory auditing of placements reports. All India Council for Technical Education, the regulatory body for technical education in India, has called upon the students, parents, and the general public not to pay any capitation fee or any other fee other than mentioned in the prospectus of the institutions for consideration of admission. Also, programs such as PGDM has to be approved by the fee regulatory committee of the state, and the institute should mention the fee in its website. As per AICT norms, the business schools are not meant to charge a fee higher than what is mentioned in the prospectus. Many business schools provide only data related to the officially recognized fee for the ranking providers, while taking from students under various other parameters, including capitation fee. Many business schools do not list the fee in the prospectus.
Please conclude.
Therefore, an exclusive regulatory body of business schools in India should be created to monitor, check, and curb such malpractices during the admission of students of business schools.
All right.
So I wish to conclude with the hope that the bill will certainly provide an adequate measure for the
government. Nothing will go on record.